Hello everyone, and thank you so much for joining us today for this special webinar as we get ready for MoodleMoot Global 2024. My name is Sandra Matz. I am the Educational Events Coordinator in the Moodle Community Team. And today, myself and other members from Moodle HQ will be joining you to run through some useful information about attending and presenting at the event. On the agenda today, we'll give a quick welcome and overview of the event, some information about the conference venue, details on registering for the conference, key dates, submitting abstracts, some tips about presenting at the event, information about the jam sessions, details on the Moodle Party, some highlights, and some of the amazing things to see and do while you're in Mérida. And we'll wrap up by answering your questions. Okay, to get us started, let me be the first to welcome you all to this information session about MoodleMoot Global 2024. MoodleMoot Global is our annual in-person conference where Moodle enthusiasts from all over the world get together to learn, collaborate, and promote lifelong learning. This year, we're heading to Mérida, Mexico, for our conference on the 22nd to the 24th of October. Last year, we had over 700 attendees from 54 different countries in Barcelona, Spain, and we're looking forward to welcoming our global Moodle community to come join us in Mexico for another exciting event that will include keynote presentations, sessions featuring talks and workshops from the community, Moodle HQ and Moodle partners and sponsors, networking sessions, and a Moodle party. We're also planning some additional activities that will be announced in the coming month. So stay tuned for more details about this. So I will now hand over to Flor, who will tell you more about this year's vibrant event location.
Hi, everyone. My name is Flor Vergara, and I'm the MoodleMoot event manager. So this year, we are heading across the Atlantic, and we'll be hosting MoodleMoot Global at the Centro Internacional de Congresos de Yucatán, or International Congress Center, or even CIC for short. And that will be in Mérida, Mexico. It's the newest and most modern venue in the region, equipped with the latest technology, 50,000 square meters, 26 meeting rooms, and a capacity for up to 10,000 attendees. It has also the LEED Green certificate, which makes it an ecologically responsible building, and also has a unique and natural cenote, which is an underground water or an underground cave which contains permanent water under the building. Very unique, yes. So the CIC is very centrally located close to the emblematic Paseo de Montejo, one of the main boulevards, and it's surrounded by many diverse hotels, delicious restaurants, lively bars, interesting museums, and other historical buildings, all walking distance. And there are different ways to arrive to the CIC, and we suggest here the most common ones. If you come from Mérida's airport, you can take the Vaivén bus and get off at the CIC stop, and you will be right at the spot. If you come from Cancun's airport, you can take the ADO buses from the airport to Mérida and get off at Terminal Paseo 60, or 60, only a few minutes walking from the CIC. And just to take into account, there's a 1 hour difference between Cancun and Mérida, so Mérida has 1 hour less. And now I hand over to Richie, who is going to talk about registering for the conference, key dates, and submitting abstracts.
Thank you very much, Flor. My name is Richard Lefroy, and I am the Learning and Media Technologist in the Moodle Academy team. We are very happy to announce that registrations for the conference are now open on our website, moodlemoot.org/2024. You can follow the links on the website to register for the conference. Look out for the large orange register button in the menu or a purple register now button on the homepage. You will need to create an account on the website first, which will then enable you to manage your registration. We do suggest that you use the same email address that you use from the Moodle.academy site, as the sites are linked, and this will avoid duplication issues when we send certificates and so on later on. So the ticket to attend the event includes access to all of the event spaces, sessions, and talks. lunch and refreshments, including morning teas, lunches, afternoon teas on all days, and social drinks, workshops and networking, a ticket to the Moodle Party on the Wednesday night, attendance at one of the optional jam sessions. Now, you will need to book these in advance, and spaces are limited, so book soon if you want to attend one of these. Note that when it comes to registering, you'll need to register for the conference first, and then you can book your jam session after that. Also note that you can only book one jam session per person. Early bird registration ends on July the 16th. On this next slide, you can see here a list of key dates, which are also available on our website. I'll speak about abstracts in just a moment, but I'll highlight here again that early bird registration finishes on the 16th of July, and then you will have until the 1st of October to register for the event. And the event itself, of course, starts on October 22nd. So this year, the jam sessions are being integrated into the main event, so there is no pre-conference. There's just the Global Partners Day on the Monday for Moodle certified partners and service providers and certified integration partners. For the rest of us, though, the event will start on the Tuesday, which is the 22nd of October, and run until the Thursday. And remember that all of the dates are for midnight in local Mérida time. So make sure you don't miss the deadline when converting to your own time zone. All right, on to submitting abstracts. So this year's conference theme is Unlocking Human Potential. And we invite Moodlers from any educational, training, or learning field to come together to learn from each other, share findings, brainstorm solutions to problems, and explore best practices. We'd love you to submit an abstract and be a presenter at the event. After all, Moodle Moots can't run without you being there presenting. This year, we have 4 different presentation methods, ranging from 15-minute presentations up to 1 or 2 hour workshops. And we will go over these in a little bit more detail in just a moment. Abstract submissions are open now and close on May the 14th, which is literally only 2 weeks from today. And we will let you know if your presentation has been accepted into the program by the 18th of June. If anyone is interested in sitting on the conference program committee, we would love to hear from you. So please get in touch by finding the Contact Us link, which is in the footer of our MoodleMoot.org website, and we will obviously get back to you. To submit an abstract, you'll need to have an account on the MoodleMoot.org website and then follow the links to become a speaker. Requirements for abstract submission are available on the website. All submissions must be in English, as this is the language spoken by our program committee. All selected speakers and poster presenters will be notified via email about the outcome of their submission by the 18th of June, including detailed information about the approved presentation method and what you can do to prepare for the event. We encourage everyone to share their presentation slides in advance of the event. To help the audience engage with your presentation, we accept PowerPoint files. So if you're using Keynote or some other presentation software, you should export as a PowerPoint file. And you'll be able to submit your files on the website closer to the date of the event. This year's Moodle MOOC Global Conference will address different topics which align with our Moodle product vision and the main areas that we will focus on when developing our future versions of Moodle. This year's 3 topics are unlocking creativity, facilitating collaboration, and optimizing outcomes. You'll also need to think about and choose one of these streams, workplace, government, not-for-profit, education, technical for Moodle admins, technical for Moodle coders or developers, and general Moodle practices for everyone. We do have a link on the website to help you think about these topics in more detail. So go and have a look at our Become a Speaker page for further ideas about addressing these topics. All right, so let me run through some quick tips and specific details on how to write a quality abstract submission and submit it to us for selection. Firstly, make sure your abstract title is clear and concise. Think about an attendee scanning through the program, deciding which sessions they might want to go to next. Will your title alone give them a clear enough indication of what your presentation is all about? Think about your stream or your audience when writing your abstract. As I mentioned before, you'll need to nominate this with your submission. You'll need to include the presenter's name, organization, and email with your submission, and you will have an option to add multiple presenters if necessary. Select your requested presentation type, and again, we'll talk more about these very soon. You'll need to enter some relevant keywords using hashtags before each term and separating them with commas. You can specify your topic, the level of your talk, beginner, intermediate, or advanced, and then any other keywords which are relevant to your abstract. Keep your abstract relevant to a global audience, as we do expect attendees from more than 50 countries at the event this year again. Keep your language simple so that those with English as a second language can easily understand your meaning. Remember that all abstract submissions must be in English so that they can be reviewed by the abstract committee. And make sure you cover the what, why, how, and summarize your key takeaway points. Once you've submitted your abstract, you can always log back into the website and update your abstract submission up until the due date on the 14th of May, which again is only 2 weeks away. And just very quickly on this next slide, don't worry about looking in too much detail at this. This is just a screenshot of the abstract submission page. You can see the fields that I've just talked about here. Obviously, you can have a proper read through all of the details and instructions here when you log on to submit your own abstract. Okay, I am now going to hand over to Mary Cooch, who will talk you through presenting at the conference. Thank you, Mary. Over to you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mary Cooch, Education Manager at Moodle. And we have, for this Moot, we have four presentation methods. So there's a short presentation, which is 15 minutes total, and we'd say 10 minutes speaking time, 5 minutes for questions. There's a longer presentation option, 30 minutes. That would be 20 minutes talking, 10 minutes Q&A. If you're less confident about speaking, you can submit a poster and we'll arrange a time when you can be standing by your poster to discuss it. Or if you like, we also have, you can do an interactive workshop between an hour and a half, giving participants hands-on experience around the different topics of the event. Now, closer to the event date, we'll send out a presenter's guide to those who've been selected to be speakers at MoodleMoot Global 2024. And the guide will cover specific details on presenting, the technical requirements, the program and presentation times, along with the venue maps and locations, information about the audio-visual recording you might be made famous on camera, and information on your poster submission if you're doing one of those. Now, in terms of presenting, I think the most important thing to remember is that we are all on your side. So there's a lovely atmosphere at these Moots. If you've been before, you'll know. If you haven't been before, you'll soon find out. So although it might be quite nerve-wracking to be standing in front of a lot of people, everyone wants to hear what you have to say and wants to support you. Also, if you're talking about your own experiences, sharing features from your site or your course, for example, make screenshots of them. We don't allow live demos, and the reason is that this can cause delays if you can't connect, if there are internet problems, if you can't log in, and we need to keep to schedule. So if you want to share something, do a screenshot. Now, in terms of what's on your slide, you may be speaking in a large room with people at the back who might not be able to see. So keep any words on your slides to one or two big words. Don't use bullet points with lots and lots of writing. And those screenshots that you might be taking, zoom into the most important feature there. And most important, keep to time. I won't say any more about that except keep to time. Now, as Richard mentioned before, we have some jams. Previously, these were before the conference, but now they're actually integrated into the main conference program and they're included in the event price. We've got three jams or activities, if you like, a developer dev jam for developers, a learning designer jam. This is for anyone who makes learning materials, course building, and we've got a UX jam, and we'll be explaining and giving information about each of those in a moment. Because they're included in the event price, you need to, when you register, you need to register quickly for the one that you want so you don't miss out on your preferred jam because places are limited. So let's hear about each of the activities in order, starting with Adrian, who's going to talk about the developer dev jam.
Yes, hello. My name's Adrian. I was one of the organizers from last year's Dev Jam. And we're looking at running the Dev Jam in a similar fashion as we did last year. So our main objectives are to get developers from around the world with a similar sort of mindset to help collaborate with each other and open up communication about Moodle development. So that might range from working on LMS or the mobile app. And we'll have many different people that we can sort of collaborate with each other on best practices and difficulties with development or areas that we want to gain help from other people to try and solve problems that may pop up. So last year, we sent out information to everybody and ran a poll to find how people wanted to go about doing the jam. Last year, we ended up doing like a live coding session. We will put it to the community again and see if they're interested in doing that or something different. And then we will also provide further information about the timings and an itinerary of what we expect to do throughout that session. And we will also let everybody know what the requirements are for the day. If we go with something similar to last year, then we may ask participants to bring a laptop with a development setup ready to go. So yeah, we're very excited to see developers from around the world and hopefully more from the American region. Thank you.
Okay, I'm back to talk about the Learning Designer Jam. And this is all about bringing together anyone who develops learning materials, experiences, whatever your actual official job title is. So we want to harness this collective brilliance and produce something great for the entire Moodle community. So we're going to pool our expertise. We're going to create examples, templates, guides and more aimed at making it easier for everyone to build great Moodle courses. For instance, to help beginners move from beginner to Moodle expert. So how it's going to work? Well, the pre-jam, so that's ahead of the Moot, we're going to collaborate and identify key opportunities. For instance, think about what do you wish you'd known yourself when you'd started? What's on your roadmap for future development? So we'll share challenges and successes and get some ideas out. And then during the jam, then you'll team up with like-minded individuals, you'll tackle specific needs and opportunities. And then towards the end of the jam, we'll come together for a show and tell session where you and your group will share what you've created and gather feedback and maybe offer assistance to others where needed. And the mission continues afterwards. So post-jam, after the jam session's finished, we'll take what we've developed and we'll contribute it to the Moodle community. For example, on MoodleNet, where your efforts can be celebrated and shared and refined by others. Okay.
Right. I am Federico. I am UX designer in Moodle. And so I'm going to talk a bit about the UX jam. And the idea of the UX jam is that we have kind of a few steps. So the first one is we're going to have a look at how Moodle design process looks like. So we how we do the discovery and then the design and how you can get involved into this process. Then we're going to take this same process, the same steps, and we're going to apply through an interactive workshop. So we can put it into practice and kind of you can see how we apply this process inside Moodle. Last year, we did, for example, some like we set up a scenario where users can achieve a specific task, and we create some like defining the problem, then we create like a brainstorm. Was a great activity with many tables and many people interacting with it. Using a lot of sticky notes and a lot of really interesting conversations. After that interactive activity, we're going to do a recap on how we use exactly kind of the same process and same steps into a real scenario on Moodle, and how we solve a specific problem, how we bring a new solution, and how we also involve, for example, with the Moodle community and other like interesting facts about how these projects go through. And after we share all this information and we interact with the attendees, we are going to do a questions and answer time, like session at the end, so we can bring some really good questions. And last year we got like really good conversations going on. So we will be really happy to have you here, and we hope it's going to be great. And next one, we're going to talk about Moodle Party.
Yes, we're going to talk about the legendary Moodle Party, which is possibly the highlight of any Moodle Moot. In previous year, we have taken over special venues for some epic nights of music, dancing, food, and wild costumes. And of course, this year, we are going to do it again. The Moodle Moot Party will be on Wednesday, 23rd of October, starting at 8 p.m. And for now, the location is on the wraps, but we can confirm that it will be very close to the conference venue and very close to probably the hotels where you're staying in. It's just like a few minutes walking. So getting there will be nice and easy. And the party, it's included in the conference price, and it will include access to the party itself, a cocktail dinner, drinks, and some surprises. More details will be released soon, including the venue and the theme. And as usual, there will be a competition for the best costume, with the winner being awarded a prize. So we can't wait to see you there. And just for now, a little bit of the location, Mérida, which is located in Yucatan, the peninsula at the east coast of Mexico. There's plenty to see and do in this historic city if you have some free time. So here are some ideas, just some ideas. You can go to the city center, where you will find the Plaza Grande, the heart of the city, and also the San Ildefonso Cathedral, which was the first one built in the continental America back to the 16th century. Also very close, you can find the Santa Lucia Park, where you will see these typical white confident chairs, and the Casa Montejo Museum, which was where Francisco de Montejo, the founder of the city, lived with his family. All the relevant museums are the Mayan World Museum, very important one, and the Macay, the Contemporary Art Museum. And if you want to eat a traditional Yucatecan meal, you can go, for example, to Museo de la Gastronomía Yucateca or to Mercado 60 or 60, very popular and with live music. If you still have time to go outside the city, there are some amazing places there. For example, the Puerto Progreso Beach, very close to Mérida, or Rio Lagartos, surrounded by amazing nature. Also the Celestun area at the west coast of the peninsula, and the Mayan Chichen Itza, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So see you all there.
Great. Looking forward to that. And just before we wrap things up and turn to questions, there are plenty of ways to keep in contact and stay up to date with everything that is going on. You can follow us on Twitter, X, at Moot Global. Keep an eye out for updates on the news section of our MoodleMoot.org website. You can join the discussion on our MoodleMoot Global group chat on Element. You can also join our MoodleMoot Global course on Moodle Academy. And keep an eye out on your email inbox, as we'll be sending updates from time to time to those who have registered for the event. And now it's time to answer any questions you have. You can type your questions in the chat or raise your hand and we will hand over to you to ask your questions. You can also visit our website to find a list of frequently asked questions at moodlemoot.org/2024/FAQs. We will be updating these questions continually in the lead up of the event. And if there's any questions as today that we don't have an answer for, we will be including them on that page too. So you can come back in a few days and find some answers, some additional answers in there. So yeah, let's see if there's any questions.
No questions for now in the chat. We can give some time to see if we come up with some questions, but we had a question about the jam session. But also Adrian answering the chat. I don't know if you want to add some more detail in that, Adrian.
I'm not sure entirely if this is accurate, but I think all of the workshops are at the same time and that's why you can only pick one. Is that right?
Yes. So the times will be confirmed, but because there's some limited availability for those jams to attend because of the size of the rooms, we just want to make sure that those who have registered before they have priority to attend those sessions. That's why we're allowing only one registration to a jam session per person. So that's the idea. And also because, you know, someone might have a lot of different skills, but it's good to give people the chance to sign up for the free jam that is more relevant to their skills, to their profile, to make the most of it. So it's going to be the time of the sessions and the length of those sessions will be confirmed when we release the program in a few weeks' time. And so it's going to be around mid-June. So that's when we will be able to provide more details. But for now, our advice is if you're interested in attending one of these jam sessions, register for the conference first, and then you can book your free place so that you don't miss up on the opportunity to attend those jams.
Yeah, just adding a bit more on there, like it's a great way to kind of interact and put your ideas together in a single space, because then it's like a lot of networking and you talk with people and you see also amazing presentations. But in the jam session, you see amazing like interactive, like how you people interact with each other in the dev jam session or the learning designer or UX jam. It's really, really good. I saw like last year and was really, really cool outcomes. We have a question from Gergely. I'm unsure to go 15 or 30 minute presentations. Are there more slots for the shorter or longer sessions, or do plan according what abstracts come in?
I think that'll be the second question, actually. We will see what we receive, all the abstracts that we receive. We always recommend that you add your preferred presentation type when you submit your abstract, and then that will be up to the program committee to review all those abstracts and then assign the length that they think it will be suitable for the program. So we always try to follow your preferred type, but in some occasions might not be possible. But hopefully that helps answer your question. If you have any questions after the session or for those who are watching the recording, you can always contact us through the contact form on the MoodleMoot.org website and we'll get back to you. If there's a question that we think it might be relevant for more people, we'll be adding it to the FAQs page on the event website. So hopefully that will help a further audience.
We have also a question from Patrick. How far in advance do you think you should book a hotel?
Well, my advice would be if you already know for sure that you're going, you can just do it at any time. Obviously, there is where the CIC is located is very central. There are plenty of hotels. Some are cheaper, some are more expensive. You have all range of hotels, but it's a very busy city. There are many events going on. There are many conferences. So don't wait until the end. I would say at least 2 months in advance to get the hotel that you want and the room that you want. That would be my advice.
There's just to add to that, there's a list of recommended hotels that Flor has put together, and they are on the event website on the venue page. So you might want to have a quick look at that.
Great. We also have one question from Pau. Where will Moodle HQ stay?
We will stay in one of those hotels that are recommended. That's all we can say. So thank you to everyone for joining us today for this session. Don't forget to register for MoodleMoot Global 2024 before the 16th of July to secure your early bird discount. And remember that if you would like to become a speaker at the event, abstract submission closes the 14th of May, which is only 2 weeks away from today. So goodbye for now, and we look forward to seeing you in Mexico in October. Thank you.